بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما يا رب العالمين. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my brothers and sisters. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty, who gathered us tonight on ta'a, who gathered us tonight on remembrance, dhikr, to unite us with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the highest level of Jannah. Allahumma ameen. Now ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the highest level of Jannah? Since we have a lot of champions in front of me, mashallah. How guys at the back? What is the highest level of Jannah? What is the name of the highest level of Jannah? Huh?
Al-Firdaus,
mashallah. Allahu Akbar. I think we need some toys here, some presents or something. Mashallah. Lord is there. Or we'll give you an extra piece of meat. Is it okay? Okay. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather us in Al-Firdaus al-A'la min al-Jannah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the prophets and messengers and as-salihin, the righteous, Allahumma ameen. And this is, by the way, my brothers and sisters, well, that should be our main goal, our main concern in this life, is to pass this test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put us through this life successfully and peacefully until we enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty. And when we enter the Jannah on the Day of Judgment, I want you to imagine yourself in this situation. I want you to picture this situation, subhanAllah. When we enter the Jannah of the Day of Judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, would say to us, "Udkhuluha bisalamin amini." So enter it peacefully. This is the call, or this is what we want to hear, subhanAllah, when we are resurrected on the Day of Judgment. "Udkhuluha bisalamin amini." Enter the Jannah peacefully. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with no punishment and judgment, Allahumma ameen. And ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to pass this dunya, this worldly life, successfully and peacefully, Allahumma ameen, while He is pleased with us subhanahu wa ta'ala and while we are walking on the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When I was little, subhanAllah, when I would study the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the biography of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you know, the prophets and messengers, I would read a lot of stories, or a lot of hardships that the prophets of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have gone through. When I used to wonder, subhanAllah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best one that Allah created, has lost his father when he was in his mother's womb, and has lost his mother, and his grandfather, and his uncle, and his wife, and his beloved kids. All of his kids passed away in his life, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except for Fatima, radiallahu ta'ala anha. She passed away 6 months after his death, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would cry sometimes, would say to Allah, "Oh Allah, I complain to you my weakness. Allah, inni ashku ilayka dha'fa quwwati. Oh Allah, I cannot, I'm very overwhelmed, oh Allah." I would read these stories and I would ask myself, why would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in these tests? And he loves him. And he said that, "Oh Muhammad, you are the best one that I've created. Oh Muhammad, you are the one whom Allah purified. You saw, oh Muhammad, you are the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven all your sins." Why would Allah test him? And then I'd read the story of Prophet Ibrahim. When he would fight with his people to convey the message of Islam with them, or between them, subhanAllah. When he was kicked out of his land, imagine, he was kicked out of his land to the desert. He migrated by himself, and he left everyone behind. His dad was one of his first main enemies, subhanAllah. Why would Ibrahim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam face these hardships? Why would Nuh sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Why would Prophet Ayyub, for 18 years, he has lost his wealth, health, his family, and his wife? Allahu Akbar, for 18 years. Why, ya Allah? Why would you test these beloved and special people, your prophets and messengers, with these hardships? And then I asked one day one of my shayukh, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them, why would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do that? He said, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are too many reasons, but because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want the hearts of his prophets and messengers to be attached to anyone but him. So he has lost his dad and his mom in a very early age. So when he would face any calamity in his life, instead of saying, oh mom, oh dad, help me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say from the beginning of his life, oh Allah, because he has no one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala almighty. And that was the hikmah that I learned. Oh, that was the hikmah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran about the test that he subhanahu wa ta'ala puts us through. All of us are tested in this life. All of us are facing sort of hardships and trials in this life. And this is the nature of this life. As shaitan sometimes may come to us, or ourselves, our nafs, when we are very overwhelmed, and ask ourselves these questions, why would Allah test me? Why does Allah test me? Why? Didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say that He loves me? Why would Allah test me? He tests you, my brothers and sisters, He tests you subhanahu wa ta'ala because He loves you. You know, in a salah we say, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. What is the meaning of a Rabb? A Rabb. A Rabb linguistically means هو الذي يربي عباده, the one he raises and fix his creations. يربي, المربي, يربي عباده, the one he fix and raise you. In a salah, every single day, at least 17 times, Alhamdulillah, Ya Rabbi Al-Alamin. We remind ourselves that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Rabb. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what fixes you. He subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that you've been designed with this with attachment to the dunya. All of us. We've been designed to attach to be attached to the dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, اعلموا أنما هذه الحياة الدنيا لهو ولعب وزينة وتفاخر بينكم وتكاثر في الأموال والأولاد. So this dunya is about what? Adornment. A lot of distractions, right? So we as humans, we get distracted a lot. And we forget Allah. We get distracted. And we forget Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He loves us, does not want us to disconnect ourselves from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why He subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sees that we need this test to return back to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will test you. He will test you. He will test you subhanahu wa ta'ala to strengthen you. Because He knows that you won't be fixed and that you will not be attached to Him with fully attachment, unless you are afflicted with a test. And just think about all the hardships that you face in your life, subhanAllah. And how close you were to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How close you were to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You would start at this time asking for some religious and spiritual help. A lot of people would come to me, right? To give them some advices. You need to do this big sister or brother, this dua, this donation and stuff, and they would follow it. For months, and as soon as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve the hardship, they forget. And they call me after, we're struggling to maintain the adhkar. I go, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put you in this in the first place. Why? Because He subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to be attached to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. He subhanahu wa ta'ala wants your heart to be connected to Him always. The ulama of Tazkiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhum says that إِنَّ لِلَّهِ غَيْرَهُ أَنْ يَرَى فِي قَلْبِ مُحِبِّهِ غَيْرًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like to see the hearts of His servants attached to anyone or to anything but Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm going to get a lunch. That's why He would fix you. I'm going to get a lunch. And that's why He would put you through His hardships. And you know, subhanAllah, He subhanahu wa ta'ala, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us more than we love ourselves, right? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved us more than the love that our mothers had for us. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day, after one of the battles, he was sitting with his companions and he saw a mother running like crazy, crying and screaming, looking for her child that she lost. And then after she found him, she started hugging him and crying, hugging and crying. And then Nabi is looking with his companions. He said to his companions, do you think that this mother would throw her kid in the fire? He said, of course not, Ya Rasulullah. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ سَلَّمْ لَاللَّهُ أَرْحَمُ بِكُمْ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأُمْ بِوَلَدِهِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty loves you more than the love that this mom has for her child. So He subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you. So when shaitan comes trying to, when your nafs or shaitan urge you to ask the question, why Ya Allah, why this me? You remind yourself of the love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has for you. And you would say to yourself, definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is following me through these hardships to get me close to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, to purify my heart. There are too many hikam, wisdoms for this that Allah mentioned in the Quran. You know, one of the main hikam is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to remind us all the time that we are His servants. And he is the Rabb. He is the Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes we forget ourselves. We forget the reality of ourselves. And we think sometimes that we are hectic. Yani we are strong and we are capable of doing everything. Right? We are capable of doing of managing our life. Some of us subhanAllah may forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completely and refer all the achievements and all the blessings he or she gain in the life to themselves. And they would say to themselves, oh, we have done this, I've done that. And some people would come to me saying that, you know, I cannot do this, or I cannot do that. Who told you that you can do anything? We are very vulnerable and weak creatures, my brothers and sisters. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. That you are weak. Person, you are a weak creature, subhanAllah. And all of us are need for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first hikmah that I'm gonna share with you tonight for the tests that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may put us through is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to remind you that you are His servant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see you humiliating and humbling yourself before Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the ibadah. The ulama would say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts you through these hardships because He wants to extract from your heart certain types of ibadah, worship, that you would not perform unless you are affected with hardships. Yani ask yourself, when would you make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and crying to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala? When would you talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this sense of urgency and emergency? When would you talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, Ya Allah, I am overwhelmed. Ya Allah, I am this, I am that, oh Allah. When would you do that? Unless you are distant with hardships. Subhanallah. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala may prolong the test because He loves to hear your voice. Because He knows that as soon as you get what you're looking for, you'll forget Him. Allah in the Quran says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ. There are some people that worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on an edge. Right? On an edge. فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ. When they are giving khayr and blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are pleased and comfortable. But when they are afflicted with hardships, they turn away. They turn away and they ask themselves, why, Ya Allah? Why? This question, my brothers and sisters, indicates that you did not know who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first hikmah for being tested is that He subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to remind us constantly that we are His servants and He is the Lord. Ya ayyuhan nas, Allah in the Quran says, Ya ayyuhan nas, أنتم الفقراء إلى الله والله هو الغني الحميد. O people, you are indeed needy, right? You are in need to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most sufficient. والله هو الغني الحميد. You are poor, and without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings, you the struggle. يا عبادي, look at the حديث القدسي. يا عبادي كلكم ضال إلا من هديته. Reflect upon this hadith. Such a powerful and inspirational hadith, the hadith القدسي. يا عبادي كلكم ضال إلا من هديته. All of you are misguided, except those whom I guide. So seek my guidance, and I will guide you. All my servants, all of you, كلكم عاد إلا من كسوته. All of you are naked except for those whom I clothe. So seek, ask me to clothe you, and I will clothe you. All my servants, all of you are hungry and thirsty except for those whom I feed. So seek my help, and I will feed you. All my servants, you are committing sins day and night, and I'm the most forgiving. Seek my forgiveness, and I will forgive you. My brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you because He doesn't want you to turn away from Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you because He does not want you to attach, this second hikmah, the second wisdom. He does not want you to be attached to this dunya, that we compete, all of us, subhanAllah. Some of us live this dunya for the sake of it. Some of us try to gain this dunya for the sake of gaining it. Their hearts are very attached to dunya. Al-haakum al-takathur. Al-takathur, which is, we've been distracted with this dunya, subhanAllah, and what it contains. Distracted. And we feel very anxious when we lose it, or very depressed when we lose it, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want you to be attached to dunya. Because you are not created for the dunya. You are not created for the dunya. You are created for the akhirah. You are created for the jannah. Why would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create Adam in jannah? To indicate, this is an indication that Adam has been created for the jannah. For the jannah, to enter jannah eventually, biiznillah rabbil alameen. And He sent him to earth to gain or to get the ticket of jannah. Right? To get the ticket of jannah. So you've been created for the jannah. And you are a traveler here. As the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to say, I'm just a traveler that rested under a tree, one of the trees, and then lifted to God and went, subhanAllah. This is, you are a traveler here. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees that you are attached to the dunya, He will afflict you with this list. Why? Because He does not want you to be attached to it. And Imam Shafi'i, one of the greatest imams, would walk with a stick in his hand all the time. And they asked him one day, oh Imam, you're still young, mashallah, why are you holding this stick with you wherever you're going? He goes, I'm reminding myself that I am a traveler. I'm a traveler. Look at the connection that this Imam radiallahu ta'ala anhum had with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm reminding myself that I'm a traveler. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test you to remind you that you are His servant. And that He is subhanahu wa ta'ala your Lord. Allah will test you to not be attached to the dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test you to forgive your sins. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep testing his servants until they meet Him subhanahu wa ta'ala with no sins. Allah, who amongst us don't have sins? All of us are sinners. All of us are sinners. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He loves you, He wants you to meet Him purified. He wants you to meet Him subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for Jannah. فهي سبحانه وتعالى may test you for the sake of that. For the sake of purifying yourself and forgiving your sins. Subhanallah al-Azim. But subhanallah, there are too many wisdoms that we're going to talk about inshaAllah. But because when our hearts, my brothers and sisters, are disconnected from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when our hearts are distracted, we will not recognize this distance. When you are distracted, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, Inna ma'al usri yusr, right? This is the surah that we comprise. Inna ma'al usri yusr, indeed with hardships comes ease. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say, after hardships comes ease. Allah said, with hardships comes ease. But how can I see this ease among the hardships? في أقرب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى. So this is the key. This is the key word of tonight. Allah tests you to maintain the connection of your heart to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you because He does not want you to be attached to anything or to anyone but Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He knows, number one, He knows when He tests you, and He knows what kind of test you can bear. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not put you through anything that you cannot bear. Which means, whatever this or hardship or challenges you face, it's suitable for you. It's designed for you. And if you would like to know that, look at people who are struggling more than you. Look at the people who are lower than you. And you would say to yourself, Alhamdulillah, I'm better than a lot of people. Alhamdulillah. Subhanallah. This is the hikmah of the test. أكثر الناس ابتلاء من الأنبياء. The most people that get this from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the prophets and messengers. So when Allah tests you, that doesn't mean he hates you. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you, whether a financial test, a physical test, a health test, a test, you know, or a hardship you have with your spouse, with your kids, with anyone, any kind of hardships. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not test you or does not put you through his hardships because he hates you. He puts you through his hardships because he wants you to come back to him. Allah in the Quran says, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِّنْ قَبْلِكَ فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَضَّرَّعُونَ. O Muhammad, we have sinned upon the nations that were before you, a lot of hardships and a lot of tests. A lot of trials. Ya Allah, why? Why would you test them, Ya Allah? لَعَلَّهُمْ يَضَّرَّرُونَ. For them to return to me. For their hearts to be humble in front of me. SubhanAllah. This is the hikmah of the test. And that's why I want you to focus. I want you to focus, my brothers and sisters. When you are in the middle of the test, I want you to focus on where's the ease, Ya Allah? The ease must be somewhere. I need to find it, oh Allah. Where's the guide me to find it, oh Allah? And Allah, He will find it. He will find this ease. You know, Nabi Salam in al-Ta'if. This story, when I read it, subhanAllah, it shakes my heart. Because Nabi Salam went to al-Ta'if in more than 7 days. 7 days walking. He said, when they're walking to Al-Ta'if sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, trying to spread Islam and trying to find supporters for Islam, they throw rocks upon him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was bleeding sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They swore him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kicked him out of the city with humiliation sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he, on the way back, he rested at one of the gardens and at one of the gardens on the way to Mecca. One of the gardens on the way to Mecca, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam rested there and he settled himself and he started crying. And he said to Allah, Allahumma inni ashku ilayka dhafa quwwati. Oh Allah, I complain to you my weakness. SubhanAllah. But look at Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the best of the teachers sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us how to focus on the goodness, on the ease, on the mercy amongst the hardships. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of the iman and the certainty that he had in his heart, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not want his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to reach Mecca until he's pleased. So he sent Addas, Mustafa al-Addas, this little servant in the garden. When the owner of the garden saw Rasulullah bleeding, he said to his servant, take this plate of grapes and go to this man, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his companion, because he went to Al-Ta'if with his companion, Usama ibn Zayd, radiallahu ta'ala anhu radha, and give him this. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, before he ate, he said, Bismillah. Bismillah. Bismillah, Abbas, this servant, this little servant, he said, Allah, who is Allah? Because Allah is the one, He created me and He created you and created everything around you. He goes, and Nabi said to him, Oh Addas, where are you from? He goes, I'm from Nineveh, it's a city in Iraq. فَقَالَ نِينَوَى The city of the Prophet of Allah, Yunus. He goes, so how did you know that? He goes, because he is my brother. I am a prophet and he's a prophet. He goes, you're a prophet? He goes, yes, I'm a prophet. عَدَّسْ سِدْ أَشْهَدُ أَلَّا إِلَّهِ So عَدَّسْ سِدْ إِسْلَامِ That was the first ease that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Rasulullah sallallahu. On the way, he's arrested in a place or a village called Nisabayn. Right? Sitting there, reading the Qur'an by himself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He heard him read the Qur'an.
Group of jinn.
MashaAllah. They have a lot of scholars and shuyukh among them, mashaAllah. What's the name?
Umar.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, Umar, and make you like Umar ibn Khattab. So a group of jinn heard Rasulullah. And as soon as they heard him, they were fascinated with the Qur'an. They went to their people and conveyed the message of Islam there, and a lot of people accepted Islam. That was in the journey itself. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, imagine, 7 days walking, and then he was kicked out, bleeding, very tired, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, very overwhelmed, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. On the way back, he's still tired. He's still very tired. Inna ma'al usri yusr. Right? Allah would not test you, but would send with a test ease and blessings and mercy, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Jibril came down while Nabi is sitting with the angel of the mountains. Oh Muhammad, if you would like me to destroy these cities by the mountains, I would do so. Muhammad said, leave him.